All right. We are filming, just so you know.
We are? We are filming now?
Yep.
Good.
All right, all right.
Because I don't trust him.
No, you shouldn't.
The things he does to me.
Yeah. Don't watch the outtakes. But, yeah, we won't have any outtakes this review.
Oh, good.
But let's see. Where do we start?
What are we doing here?
Ed and Tom, St. Pete Cigar, the banner behind us. That's where we are.
Yeah.
Doing the usual monthly cigar review. I think we might be a little late, but I was stuffed
it's
up.
It's close.
Yeah, it's close.
Yeah. And what are we doing, Tom?
I was stuffed up, but what are we doing?
Yeah, we've been sick, man, or everybody around here.
The Quesada.
Oktoberfest.
What do they call this one?
One of Tom's favorite cigars.
Yeah, a good cigar.
At the moment.
6x65, it's a big one.
Yeah. Huge.
Yeah, goes for about $8.95.
And you've been smoking the.
No, I've been smoking
a lot of these cigars. Yeah.
I've been buying, I'm probably the biggest purchaser of them.
One of them, anyway.
Yeah, at least one of them. Besides you, maybe.
Yeah. Yeah, and Bob.
Right. But yeah, it's excellent cigar. We gave away the review, but who cares?
Great cigar.
Yeah, I mean, it's all Dominican. Wrapper is Dominican. I don't know how to pronounce that. Cibao Valley. Cibao?
Yeah.
Valley.
Let me see. I don't have my glasses on.
Binder is Dominican Republic. See, Dominican.
Oh, Cibao. Cibao Valley.
Cibao.
Cibao.
Okay.
Cibao.
So, and then the binder, Dominican. The filler is Dominican. Cuban seed, Criollo.
Yeah.
And then it says, and Orlo Viso, and then Lajero. So it's weird context they put it in.
Yeah. It's a great variety of tobaccos.
Yes. Dominican Puro, though.
Yeah.
So that's, you know.
Exactly.
Usually I don't smoke a lot of them.
And, of course, the Criollo probably will bring a lot of taste to the cigar. So
it does. I think it brings in some sweetness and all that stuff. Yeah, what do you get?
The toast still smells real good.
It's kind of, I don't get a lot of odor off of it, smell.
I get a little bit.
Yeah, like it's not real strong like you
don't
would expect.
Don't forget we've been sick.
Yeah. I'm pretty clear today.
Yeah.
Last Saturday I wasn't.
It's still tough to.
It's real kind of a mild smelling.
But it's not a mild cigar.
No, this is full bodied, man.
Yeah, it's a mild, nice mild.
It's almost like
almost getting into the barn smell.
Maybe slight, yeah.
Yeah. And a slight, yeah.
Yeah, not a local like it, but look at the wrapper, man, how shiny it is. It's a nice, beautiful, shiny wrapper. Not a lot of veins or anything crazy. Well put together.
Did you,
You're looking for a cut? I saw your V-cutter.
Yeah.
Here, wait. I'm stepping out of frame.
Oh, that's not mine, but I'll use that one.
I thought I saw you with your V-cutter.
Yeah, I had it.
And I'm doing something a little different.
You're going to punch it. Okay.
I've been having better luck with the punch on these suckers.
Yeah. I've been doing the V, and not a problem.
I could see that working good, too, just
because
I find if I take...
The V just puts a beautiful sliver.
I've been finding if
you can see that there. Look at that.
Yeah, and I'm doing the...
And he's doing the punch.
And the reason being, if I take the whole top of the cap off,
sometimes
it's too loose of a draw. So I find that the punch or the V cut...
The V,
kind of just leaves just enough exposed.
Yeah, it's too big of a of a diameter to cut the whole cap.
And somebody told me that on the internet. I wish I remembered his name.
Yeah, I agree with that. That's absolutely.
But I've been doing it ever since the guy told me.
Because then you got such a free draw, and you might not even,
it's just airy.
Yeah, exactly.
And pairing with water, of course.
Yeah, me too.
For the record.
And I'm going to start mine up here.
Me too. 65, it takes a little while to light.
Wow.
So I'll edit this part.
First draw, absolutely delicious. Starts out really great, this cigar.
Yeah, I should have probably brought a triple flame with me. Mm. Overheating this lighter. Poor little thing.
Yeah.
Now we're good.
Grab a man's lighter.
We're good. Yeah, the grenade. We're good. It's close.
But,
nice first draw.
Mm-hmm.
Every now and then, you have to do a burn correction
nice
on these.
Nice coffee roast.
Yeah.
Taste.
Yes. Right off the bat.
Right off the bat.
Like a black coffee.
Yeah. It's really
incredible. It doesn't screw around with flavors.
No.
It just kind of comes out.
Comes right out.
Yep.
And
I think what will build is the body, and maybe the strength of the cigar will build as you,
And it builds. Yeah.
As you go further on.
Builds a nice, just flavorful. Yeah. But as we go along, we'll try to determine what the flavors are.
Yeah, I mean,
I always smoke it so.
I think I'm just.
If I'm playing cards or something.
Right, right.
Yeah, and.
I think I'm
can't
just
get
coffee.
Yeah.
I think it starts out simple and gradually becomes a little complex as you go. And we've smoked so many of them, you'd think we'd know it by heart by now, but.
Wow.
You just
very nice. Never had one with a bad draw.
No.
I've smoked several.
Smoke more. I think I've smoked like 12 or 13.
Oh, yeah, at least.
13.
At least.
Well, I'm hoarding them,
Yep.
So I'll buy some and stash them.
Yeah. I was smoking one, two a day for a while.
Yeah, me too. Me too. I had to stop doing that, man. It was getting expensive. But yeah, you want to, let's see how long we've been. Yeah, we've been rambling six, seven months.
Yeah, okay.
So we can dig
into it. Let's go ahead and smoke the first third, and we'll be back with some good results.
Back.
Still.
First third.
It's parrot with water.
Steel burn line, which is fine. Construction is good.
Yeah.
We've been smoking 40 minutes.
Wow.
On the first third, so it's obviously a.
Yeah, well, so far so good. It's pretty much lots of coffee.
Black.
Yeah.
Black espresso-ish. Nice, like espresso type.
And then I got a touch of earthiness, very slight, into a woody flavor.
Yeah, and I miss the earthy, but I get the little woody, aftertaste, I guess, or a tinge of woodiness, whatever you'd say. So it's not the most complex of flavor profiles.
Did get some of some chocolate in the beginning, a little bit.
Yeah, we didn't mention that. Yeah, the bitter chocolate.
And. But it's smoking very nice. The draw is awesome. And
that's perfect draw.
Perfect draw.
With a punch in the beaker.
My wrapper here is so nice and shiny, oily.
Me too.
Yeah.
I don't think the camera can catch it. But I'm trying to hold it in the light. Beautiful wrapper.
Yeah. Very, very nice, yeah.
Yeah, construction's good.
Criollo wrapper.
I think.
Is that a Criollo tobacco? I forgot.
Criollo. It has some Criollo in the filler.
In the filler.
Right.
What's the wrapper again?
Dominican.
That's a Cibon?
Cibao Valley.
Cibon Valley.
Right. Rapa. So wherever that.
Whatever that means.
I assume it's a location.
It actually looks almost like a Criollo wrapper.
Yeah, and it kind of burns a little wavy, like a Criollo can.
A little veiny, pretty veiny, but smooth veins on the cigar.
Nothing ugly.
No.
And we forgot to mention the size we're smoking is called the Uber, which is
Uber.
German for what? Big?
Yeah, upper, bigger.
Right.
Yeah.
And the smaller size is called the Bavarian, which is 5.5 by 52. Yeah. Obviously, we've
smoked. Bavarian is just the name of the region in Germany, Bavaria.
Right. And we've smoked plenty of both.
And, so they make the two sizes, and that's it.
Yep.
The other thing I like to mention is I just happened to have last week a Oktoberfest beer. With this cigar.
Oh, yeah.
And it was absolutely great to smoke with.
I would try it, but I just can't stand beer, so I.
No, huh?
Yeah. I mean, maybe one day I'll try it. just because of its, that's what it's marketed
towards. I don't
towards.
Drink much at all, but I like a beer now and then, and in the summertime, it's awesome.
Supposedly, that's what it's intended for. That's what this cigar is blended towards, the Oktoberfest beer. And some people have suggested that as well, so maybe one day. And we through the nose is pepper. We didn't mention that.
Slight pepper.
Yeah.
Not a burning pepper, but a very nice pepper.
Yeah,
you can let the whole smoke through the nose and it doesn't burn.
Mm-hmm.
And then nice wood here I'm getting. Very nice woody
it's
flavor.
It's increasing, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
What kind is it, cedar to you?
Yeah, I would go with the cedar, yes.
Like a cedar?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Actually, I just noticed that as you were saying the sentence.
Yeah. Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, so it's not a lot of crazy complex flavors going on, but it's just really good. I don't know if that is a good way to put it, but
right,
it's just really
it's
good.
It's not a very complex cigar.
No.
As far as the flavors.
Right.
There's about 3-4 flavors. That's about it.
Right. I don't.
But they're very pleasant flavors.
Maybe it's the
very pleasant.
The way that they're delivered, I guess, is the what makes a cigar. It's
yeah.
A good.
And I'll tell you what. Try that with a beer if you guys get one of these out there. They run between $8 and $9.
Yeah, I think they say
some shops might be a little more, some might be a little bit less.
Well, I think the MSRP is about
$8.95
for the
how much? $8.95
for the Uber.
Yeah. Well, that's what I charge you.
Yeah, and I think that's MSRP, I believe.
Yeah.
I don't know for a fact, but
that's the going price. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean it's worth it.
Some places you're gonna pay more because of taxes, you know.
New York, for example.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying to
see
if there's anything on their website. There's not a whole lot. They just mentions how there's a cigar tenant Oktoberfest for cigar smokers, et cetera, et cetera. Has blended a cigar.
That's a great compliment with that beer.
It said it's blended. Mm-hmm. They blended a cigar specifically to be paired with flavorful Marzen style beer.
Yeah.
So that's their intention.
Yeah.
Exactly. Whether it's marketing or.
Well, it was. It did.
There's a guy.
Yeah. It tastes very good. So.
Yeah.
Oh, we just got a customer in. So.
You want to wrap it up for
the
first
serve? Yeah, we can wrap it up for now because we'll be back with the next.
That's all there is to say. Yeah, exactly.
All right.
We'll be back.
See you.
Back.
Back, and we have some.
You had some wacky burn.
Yeah.
A little wacky burn.
Yeah, a little bit of bad burn, but not bad.
Yeah, nothing crazy.
And nice notes in this part here.
Yeah, well, most of till the halfway point is when it started to pick up, I think.
Yeah.
And we both
picked up a little bit. Then the. Coffee-ish came in, a little chocolate, and then I'm getting the slight cinnamon spice.
Little
very
bit,
nice.
A little bit like a
sweetness.
Like maybe people would perceive it as a sweet spice, which is cinnamon.
A nice sweet spice.
Which is cinnamon to you. But
yeah, it is.
Maybe the common the common palate, I guess, like
yeah.
me. Somebody like me, basically. That'd be the way I would describe it. Sweet spice. Bitter chocolate, dark chocolate.
Well, very nice, yeah.
Still easy pepper in the nose.
Very easy. Nothing harsh at all.
Teeny bit of woodiness I still get.
You got a touch, yeah.
Teeny bit. Oh, the ash is holding nice too, man. Look at that. Which I'm going to tap right here. Full-bodied.
Yeah. You feeling it?
No.
No?
I'm good, man. Surprisingly, I thought I haven't eaten today. I'm good, man.
But
good
it smokes
go.
Very nice. It's an easy cigar. It's not very complex. It's got about 4 complexities in here.
Yeah, but what's the deal? Why is it so good? I don't know how to
describe it. Yeah, it's just the flavor leaves your palate very clean.
Yeah,
you have no bad yep. taste on your palate whatsoever. So it makes it a very nice cigar, in my view.
And something, yeah, there's just something about it that makes it exceptional. I don't, because if you just take our flavor descriptions,
that,
it doesn't
pepper
sound.
Pepper through the nose is delicious, actually, you know.
Pepper picked up a little bit, man. I just put a good amount through the nose. Did you try letting
Nice cinnamon. I just got.
I let a little more through my nose that last puff.
Yeah.
It made me water up a little bit in the eyeballs.
Oh, wow.
Yep, yep.
Come on.
You can't see it on the camera, but.
Damn, he's crying.
A little bit.
Damn, but let me try that.
I'm in a good amount, not, you know, maybe a half. Made me well up a little bit. You kind of feel it right here. Like right here.
You're right.
Nothing crazy. It's not like not like a crazy black pepper.
No.
But
really delicious.
Just got to pay attention.
Wow.
Got to pay attention.
Yeah, if you have a chance to catch some of these.
Buy them.
Try them because they're very limited. And if you're lucky to get one, go ahead and get it because...
Yeah,
you'll enjoy it.
I can't remember how many boxes
they have. And have a nice beer with it, dark beer.
Yeah, if I drink beer, I would certainly do it.
A nice dark beer.
And you know, maybe I will one day.
Yeah.
Who knows?
Yeah.
Maybe next year.
But
is this a yearly?
Other than that, you have anything on your website going on?
No, nothing.
We
special.
Have our event next Friday.
Well, by the time they see this, the event will either have just happened. I don't know when this is coming out.
Ours?
This review.
Oh, okay.
I don't know when it's coming out. But yeah, Tatuaje is what day?
Tatuaje is coming here next week.
What day is that?
The 11th? That is the 11th. I think it's Veterans Day, everybody tells me.
So this review may come out the Sunday after that. I don't know.
Okay.
But whatever. If people who are in the area already know about it.
Yeah, exactly.
So it was probably a good event by the time you see this.
Oh, yeah.
We've already...
As always, we serve food with our events. Great door prizes. I think they're giving away some lighters this time, all kinds of stuff, and of course, lots of cigars.
Is that the last event of the year? 2011, is that the last
event?
That's
the last one, yeah.
All right, cool.
Yeah. Then I'm going to start out in January again.
Right.
Yeah, I already have somebody coming. I forget who it is, but...
Cool. Well, we got time.
We'll announce it, yeah.
Yeah. I think the only thing I'm doing is the Kiss My Ash.
Kiss Your Ash?
Kiss My Ash radio. Which is,
okay. When is that?
I don't know.
Happening.
I think it's the 19th. I don't remember. Keep an eye on the website.
Yeah.
It's no big deal. It's only a small segment.
Yeah.
I'll try to get some meaningful conversation in there.
What else going on? Nothing else.
That's it.
That's about it.
And how many boxes did they make of these? Like 5,000?
Yeah. They all gone.
And it's a yearly release.
And
right?
Yeah, it's an yearly release.
Cool.
And. I was lucky enough to get about six eight more boxes. So I did get quite a few. I was pretty lucky in that.
Yep.
And they're all gone. We have no more.
Close to no more.
Yep.
But yeah. So
we're out of them.
Pretty much. Yeah. By the time they see this, you'll be out.
Mm-hmm.
So, but anyway, I got nothing else.
Let's go back and smoke our last segment.
Lester.
And see what else we get out of this.
Yep.
We'll see you very shortly.
We'll be back.
Yeah.
Beautiful
cigar.
Well,
what do you think?
Beautiful, beautiful cigar.
Yeah.
That's all I...
Did it get any better for you?
Beautiful cigar. Yeah.
Wow. What a delicious...
Nice sweetness. Can. Nice sweetness.
Yeah.
I got Bill over here showing his porn.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Nice sweetness.
Really, the cinnamon came in really strong.
Like cinnamon and dark chocolate.
And dark chocolate.
Mixed up.
Yeah.
So, uh-huh.
You get the dark chocolate first.
Well, the cinnamon was like more on
then
the finish.
Then it turns into like almost a woody, and then it gets the nice cinnamon spice.
It's, yeah. And the pepper stayed about the same.
Pepper stayed, yeah, very nice.
And I started huffing it down a little in the last third, but...
Well, I got busy, so...
Right.
But beautiful. Anyways...
beautiful cigar.
Excellent smoke.
Yep.
Excellent smoke. I recommend it highly.
One of my favorites.
Yeah.
Box worthy. It's worth a box purchase. It's worth the money, I guess.
Worth the money.
And we've been smoking an hour and 2 hours and 10 minutes.
In 10 minutes, yeah.
130 minutes.
Exactly.
According to your math.
Wow.
Thanks to Bill.
Mm-hmm.
And, but now I'm curious, how would you compare the Casa Magna Domus Magnus to this one? Do you like that one better?
Yeah.
I mean, I think
Domus Magnus is a really nice cigar. It's made by the same people.
Same company, yeah.
And, it's not as full a body, but it's loaded.
More complex.
Loaded with flavors, delicious flavors. But not to take nothing away from this.
I was just curious.
Because this is a different cigar.
It's just an idle question. Yeah, I was just curious.
Right.
Because I think the same, but this is up in my top.
Of the list.
My top, yeah. I mean, the Domus Magnus may be my number one favorite in terms of flavor, at least right now.
I'll tell you what, anybody... gives me a chance to buy a $30 cigar or the Domus Magnus, I'll go for the Domus Magnus.
Well, actually, I'd probably take this over most.
You know,
This is one of my favorites, too.
That's a great smoke for the money. I mean, you can't beat it.
When everybody releases their top cigars of 2011.
Does it have your seal of approval?
Oh, yeah, a bunch of times.
Yeah, there you go. You heard it right here
beautiful
from
cigar.
Tom.
It's a beautiful cigar.
And to view the reviews, you already know, it's tomcigars.com. StokeyReview.com. StPeteCigar.com.
Yeah, they know the deal.
So
they all know us.
Yeah.
Just the flavors are simple, but it's just rich.
Yeah.
Like a rich,
very, very delicious.
Yeah. Rich.
A lot better ending than the beginning.
It builds up. The flavors stay. The core flavors are almost the same, except for that cinnamon.
Exactly.
But beautiful. Beautiful cigar.
Good smoke.
I can't say enough good things
about it. I'm going to smoke it until my finger, until I put my little piercer on it.
Yep, look how small I got that going.
Yeah.
But yeah, worth the going price.
It's worth it. Absolutely.
If you can get a box of them, I would get a box and just.
Yeah, if you can get them out there, man.
Smoke them up.
Yeah. You won't be sorry.
Uh-uh.
That is for sure.
Full bodied.
Yep.
Full bodied. But not an ass kicker. It's noon. And I haven't eaten, and I'm fine, you know.
Wow.
No stomach.
Good for you.
No crazy head buzz.
No?
Nope.
Wow.
No shakes. Steady as a...
Wow.
A little shaky, but not...
Yeah.
But not bad. Nothing.
No.
Nothing noticeable.
No.
So, yeah.
And, okay.
That's all I got.
I have nothing else either. So, until next time, I say keep on puffing.
We'll be back and all that stuff.
And yes, we'll be back in
December.
About a month.
Yeah. See you.
So long.